7th, with the premiere of the Cecil B. DeMille movie.
Walk of Fame used to start at Sycamore, but in 1994 it was expanded a block west to La Brea Avenue. New stars have been added along the sidewalk here, as have distinctive new street lights resembling studio lights. Ahead and to our left, we can see Hollywood and La Brea, and a gleaming silver gazebo called the Gateway to Hollywood. Topped with a spire which reads Hollywood. On the top of which you can just see a small statue of Marilyn Monroe, in her famous pose from the 7-year itch. All of this is held aloft by silver, life-size statues of screen goddesses, representing 4 different races of people who have made it in Hollywood. The ladies are Anna Mae Wong, Dolores Del Rio, Mae West, and Dorothy Dandridge. As we turn right into Sunset Boulevard, we see on the right corner an El Pollo Loco restaurant. Although not a normal point of interest on a sightseeing tour, here in Hollywood, the rules change somewhat. Several years ago, a struggling actor trying to make ends meet had a job on this corner advertising the restaurant specials dressed as a chicken. This actor was Brad Pitt. Ahead to our left, we can see the Sahara Motor Hotel. This is where they filmed scenes from the movie Species, and where Jim Carrey lived when he first came to Hollywood.
Thank you.
Guild of America, designed to represent schools of film. Inside, there are three state-of-the-art movie theaters for directors to preview their films. The DGA represents a...
On our right-hand side, we can see the Laugh Factory, a stand-up comedy club which opened in 1979. It hosted stars such as Richard Pryor, Joe Seinfeld, and it still showcasing both established and new talent every day. We are now officially entering the world-famous Sunset Strip, famous for its glittering nightlife, packed with nightclubs, hotels, and restaurants. In fact, straight ahead of us, to the right, partly hidden behind the billboards and trees, stands the noble Chateau Marmont Hotel, discreetly catering to the stars. Built in 1929, the Chateau Marmont has been home to stars including Errol Flynn, Bob Dylan, Clark Gable, John Lennon, and Marilyn Monroe. In front of the hotel are the private bungalows where John Belushi died in 1982. Today, regulars in... They were all unknowns, waiting to be discovered. Opposite this stop, to our left, is the House of Blues in the corrugated tin building, founded by Dan Aykroyd of the Blues Brothers fame. It has hosted such music greats as Eric Clapton, James Brown, Tom Jones, Chuck Berry, The Kinks, Marianne Faithfull, and many, many more. You can check the schedule out to see who's playing. We pull away from the Comedy Store. Look to your left at the large white hotel, the Mondrian, with its virtual tour of Mahogany Wall sculpture meeting guests. This hotel is owned by Ian Schrager, along with the French designer Paul Scharf, documented at the Marlowe Design Hotel. Stars such as Leonardo DiCaprio, Drew Barrymore, Cameron Diaz, and Courtney Love have all parted at the Mondrian Sky Bar, a favorite with all of young Hollywood. Of the chain. The building is typical of a style of architecture called googie, a style very popular in California in the 1950s. Directly ahead, you can see the striking blue and green facade of the Civic Design Center, showcasing the best of modern interior design, the professional interior designers, architects, decorators, and dealers. Also located here, together are considered the center.
design in North America. If you want to see the latest ideas on home decor, this is the place to hang out. Cyrus, Lindsay Lohan, Kim Kardashian, and Latoya Jackson actually get behind the bar and create their own celebrity milkshake. Inside the store, there is a
world over as representing the city's unique character more than any other symbol. That's why it's in high demand for use in many movies. The surprising thing about the show is that it's copyrighted.
There was one near the start of each street. Instead of being yellow, as throughout the rest of Los Angeles, they are painted silver, which is felt to be much more appropriate for Beverly Hills. You may also notice that there is an alley running behind these houses. This is where the garbage cans are kept, so that the garbage trucks can drive down them to pick up the garbage without spoiling the beautiful landscape streets of Beverly Hills. You may remember the opening shots of Down and Out in Beverly Hills with McNulty, where he starts off in one of these very same alleys. Our next stop, stop 7, on 3rd Street, behind the Beverly Hills Courthouse, which is where some of you might want to transfer onto the yellow route to Santa Monica. Please stay seated, though, until the bus comes to a complete stop.
Run across America.
turned around and just kept on going. Dating from 1909, Santa Monica Pier is one of Santa Monica's most glorious survivors, having withstood both storms and developers. It is a great place to relax and have some fun. The vintage carousel, built in that chair as you leave the bus, and try not to leave any of your belongings behind. Santa Monica Bay sweeps around. It's along this section that the exclusive beach community of Malibu is located. Malibu covers 26 miles of this northern coastline and is home to many stars, including Barbara Streisand and Britney Spears. If any of you plan to return here later, you might be interested to know that the row of buildings lining the beach just north of here is an area called the Gold Coast. Many fabulous beach houses of the rich and famous are located here for many years. The most famous of which is the 110-room beach house, which you can call something that big, built by William Randolph Hearst for his mistress, the actress Marion Davies. In its heyday, this beach house hosted a wide range of Hollywood stars, including Charlie Chaplin, Bart Gager, Cary Grant, and Gloria Swanson. Today, only the historic pool and guest house remain from this original beach house. But we are glad to say that they are now open for the public to use as part of the newly opened Annenberg Community Beach House. This new beach house is part of the original city plan laid out by its founder, John Hurst Jones.
with their skills and tricks. The three-block promenade is a great place to hang out, admiring the palm and jacaranda trees that line the street and being photographed by the giant metal and totally dinosaur mounds spread out along it. Coming up ahead on the right-hand side, Olivia Newton-John spent her honeymoon here. The massive Moreton Bay fig tree at the front of the main building was planted in 1890, the sapling having been brought from Australia and used by a sailor to pay for his drinks in a local Santa Monica bar. It is now some 80 feet tall. So please, take care as we come to our next stop, 3rd Street Promenade. Santa Monica visitors' information cards located on the palm. All the other types of palm trees that you see around Los Angeles were in fact originally imported, many of them from Hawaii. In fact, most of the trees in Los Angeles are not indigenous to California. You have to remember, we are really basically just a desert here. Remind you that your ticket is in fact your passport to unrivaled freedom, allowing you to get off at any of our many stops, have a look around, and then get back on the bus at a later time. Please ensure that you keep your ticket in a safe place, as you will need it if you do choose to leave the bus. Alternatively, you can visit one of the many restaurants and cafes, where they are sure to satisfy your appetite for both food and people watching. Many people consider this street to be Santa Monica's very own Rodeo Drive. those of you wishing to get off here, please take care as you leave the bus. And make sure that you have all your belongings with you. Joan Crawford lived here for some 30 years, a mansion the scene of an often turbulent domestic life, as told by our adopted daughter Christina Crawford in Mommy Dearest. Arnold Schwarzenegger also had his family home in the area. Also in Brentwood is the former home of O.J. Simpson. This is the place that O.J. Simpson returned to after his nationally televised 60-mile freeway chase in June 1994. By almost 100 million viewers. It was also here that investigators later found a bloody glove and traces of the victim's blood. The former football star was forced to move out of his Brentwood estate when he defaulted on his mortgage payments, and the five-bedroom Tudor mansion was sold as a foreclosure. As we drive along San Vicente, you will notice all the coral streets that line the center of the road. Not many people notice, but this Seasons Hotel, built in 1928 and a popular haunt of the stars. Of course, it was made even more famous in the film Pretty Woman, as the hotel where Richard Gere stayed with Julia Roberts. Warren Beatty lived in the penthouse suite here for over a decade, declaring it to be the only place to live in Los Angeles. And Elvis Presley stayed here in his early days in Hollywood, with fans sending love notes up to him tied to helium balloons. Other long-term celebrity guests include Elton John, Mick Jagger, Andrew Lloyd Webber, and Cary Grant. The hotel epitomizes the highest level of service, as evidenced by the occasion when Emperor Hirohito of Japan stayed at the hotel, and the staff spent a week peeling rings for him. Rodeo, a beautiful cobblestone street lined with famous shops that even has its own ambassador to greet the tourists. Look for him in his black top hat and red coattails. On your right, just past Dayton Way, is Harry Winston, the King of Diamonds, who established the tradition of loaning jewelry to Hollywood stars for high-profile events such as the Oscars. On your left, just past the pedestrian crossing at 343 Rodeo Drive, is the solid silver front of the Prada store, with no signage and shop windows in the floor. This epicenter store, designed by Rem Koolhaas, was opened in 2004 as a one-of-a-kind mix between a store and a conceptual art piece. While you're looking around at the stores, keep your eyes open for who might be out shopping. Stars often shop in the stores, such as Armani, Gucci, Prada, Valentino, and Versace. Rodeo Drive is a living theater of fashion, art, and an endless parade of fascinating people from all around the world. On the other side of Santa Monica Boulevard lies residential Beverly Hills. These broad residential streets were laid out by the landscape architect and planner Wilbur Cook. He designed the streets so that they gently curve, therefore giving the area a more countrified feel. You may also notice that each of the streets is planted with a different type of trees. Rodeo Drive is lined with giant ficus trees, while the street to the east, Beverly Drive, is lined with palm trees. You may in fact recognize this palm-lined street from the opening sequences of the popular classic TV show, The Beverly Hillbillies. Looking ahead on our right, we can see an eight-story tower topped with a green and gold tiled dome and gilded spire, sitting on top of a Spanish Renaissance building. This is Beverly Hills City Hall. This building was made famous when it was the police station in all three Beverly Hills Cops films, where a Detroit detective, played by Eddie Murphy, meets the local Beverly Hills Cops. We are now approaching our next stop, stop 7, on 3rd Street, behind the Beverly Hills Courthouse, which is where this bus will terminate. Please, stay seated though. We are now entering the beautifully maintained lawns, gardens, and parklands of decorated with works of art, lined with a variety of trees, Burton Way and the streets that you live in eloquently proclaim that they too are part of Beverly Hills. The focal point of the lawns in the center of the road are Mexican fan palms. These tall trees are an icon of LA, especially in the Beverly Hills and Hollywood areas. Is moving, it's important that you keep your arms inside the vehicle and look out for low-hanging branches on the trees. If any of you just visited the Los Angeles County Museum of Art, you may have recognized it from the movie L.A. Story, in which Steve Martin skated through its art galleries. Now, as we approach Fairfax, the building on your right was once the May Company department store, and has a gold mosaic corner tab resembling a perfume bottle. Just beyond,
On the far side of Fairfax, still on your right-hand side, is Johnny's Coffee Shop restaurant, one of the few remaining classic examples of googie or coffee shop modern architecture from the 50s. Now closed, this is still used as a movie location and was featured in movies such as Gone in 60 Seconds with Nicolas Cage, the Quentin Tarantino movie Reservoir Dogs, and in The Big Lebowski, where John Goodman tells Jeff Bridges that he can get him a tow by 3 p.m. To our right, you can see the gated housing area of Park La Brea. Park La Brea is a unique community which encompasses not only the length of this street, but extends over 167 acres of prime real estate and is now home to over 10,000 residents. Originally, the complex was to be an area of garden apartments that began development in 1939. World War II halted the development. After the war, returning veterans were desperately seeking homes for their families, so the developer decided to build 18 more apartment towers in the park in an effort to assist the brave soldiers in setting up new lives.
As we head to Farmers Market, we'll pass on our left the Writers Guild of America. And it's here that many of the scripts for movies and television shows are sought out by producers. If you have a script or a story, or just an idea, you can register it here for a modest fee, and who knows, you may be discovered. You'd be far from the first. It was born, making a profit by charging the farmers 50 cents a day in rent. By 1941, the market had been expanded and the famous clock tower was installed, inscribed with the wording, "An idea." Today, it is still a working farmer's market and has over 100 shops, restaurants, and grocers. It's a delightful place to shop, dine, and explore. Ahead of us is the Grove, which is a shopping center with a difference. Over 60 fashion stores are set in an outdoor Disneyland-style center connected with the farmer's market by a double-deck, open-top trolley car. This is a must-visit location, and we'll be stopping here for those of you who wish to shop, walk around, eat, ride the trolley car, or just soak up the atmosphere. Soon we'll be crossing. This made it perfect for LA's entertainment industry. Since it's located only a few blocks from the music scene on Sunset, Cantor's became a great place to go after a show. Also, because of its proximity to many studios, it became a favorite hangout for many people in the movie industry. Today, it's still a great place to run into a celebrity or two. Up ahead is the Silent Movie Theater, built in 1942, long after talkies had taken over. By John and Dorothy Hampton, it ran for decades as the country's only fully functioning silent movie theater. Today, it's the home of Cine Family, an organization of movie lovers devoted to finding and presenting interesting and unusual programs of exceptional, distinctive, weird, and wonderful films. It's been restored to its original vintage Art Deco design, along with the installation of a new screen and sound system, with the purpose to introduce a new generation to the joys of cinema. On our right is Fairfax High School, where every Sunday they have a flea market for the sexy, hip, and groovy crowd, called the Melrose. We're now going to stop so you can explore this part of Melrose Avenue. Please remember to keep your ticket as you'll need it to reboard the next bus.
Thanks for joining us. For your own safety, please remember to remain seated at all times while the bus is moving. Perhaps one of the things that really put Melrose on the map was the TV show Melrose Place. There really is a Melrose Place, but it's about a mile further west. It's just a short street with no residences on it. Coming up on our left in a brick building is Groundling, LA's premier improv company, with alumni that include many of today's stars such as Phil Hartman, Will Ferrell, Lisa Kudrow, and John Lovitz. The Groundlings also has a school of improvisation offering classes to both the professional actor and beginner. The school also puts out many great comedy writers such as Bill and Sherry Steinkelmer, who were the producers of the TV show Cheers.
Okay, I know some of you are getting hungry. Coming up at our next stop is the world-famous Pink's Hot Dogs. Pink's Hot Dogs has been a staple of LA life since 1939. Founded by Paul and Betty Pink, they actually started with a pushcart on the corner of Melrose and La Brea. Today, the line always seems endless, but no one complains as the wait is definitely worth it.
You might see the giant sky backdrop for the huge outside water tank used for filming the parting of the Red Sea in the Ten Commandments and the whale tail scene in Star Trek IV. As we approach Bronson, look to your left and you will see, set back about 500 feet, the original famous Paramount gates used in the movie Sunset Boulevard. Of course, not all of the studios are as famous as Paramount, and to our right, we can see Raleigh Studios, which has been here since 1915. These studios actually built one of the world's first sound stages here, complete with a glass top so light could enter without disrupting sound recording. Famous movies made here include the original A Star Is Born with Janet Gaynor and Whatever Happened to Baby Jane, starring Betty Davis and Joan Crawford. Ahead. Founded in 1899, this is the final resting place of many movie celebrities. Hollywood's first great screen lover, Rudolph Valentino, who caused women to faint in theaters, is buried here. Other stars here include Douglas Fairbanks Sr., Douglas Fairbanks Jr., Janet Gaynor, Tyrone Power, Nelson Eddy, and Faye Ray. Directors Cecil B. DeMille and John Huston, gangster Bugsy Siegel, and punk rock legends Johnny and Dee Dee Ramone are also here. My favorite, though, is the gravestone of Mel Blanc, the voice of over 1,000 cartoon characters, including Bugs Bunny, Daffy Duck, and Porky Pig. His gravestone reads, "That's all, folks." So, we are now approaching our next stop, stop 15, just before Santa Monica Boulevard. Please, do not stand up until the bus has come to a complete stop. For those of you wishing to visit the Hollywood Forever Cemetery, please exit the bus here and then turn left along Santa Monica Boulevard, and about halfway along the block, you will find the grand entrance to the cemetery. Thank you.
As we turn, we can see on our left the original broadcasting tower of KTLA Television, the local Channel 5 here in Los Angeles, which was started in 1947. KTLA pioneered on-the-spot news coverage in 1949 with their live coverage of a child lost down a well. It was also the first station to telecast live from a helicopter and the first to use a mobile news van. In fact, KTLA's current News at 10 is still the number one primetime news broadcast in LA. In 1922, Sid Grauman moved the Entertainment Center from downtown Los Angeles to Hollywood Boulevard when he built the Egyptian Theater, 5 years before he built his famous Chinese Theater. The Egyptian theme is not surprising when you realize that the tomb of King Tut was found just 2 years earlier in 1920, and Egyptology was highly fashionable. The Egyptians' grand opening was also the occasion for Hollywood's very first red carpet movie premiere. The movie that opened the new theater was Robin Hood, starring Douglas Fairbanks. Staged in typical Grauman fashion with bright lights, stars, and a red carpet, that initial gala inspired countless subsequent movie premieres, a Hollywood tradition which continues to this very day. Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are approaching the end of this particular route, where you can get off and explore the heart of Hollywood, perhaps visiting Madame Tussauds Hollywood or the Chinese Theatre with its world-famous forecourt, where you can also book the original and best two-hour movie stars homes tour with Starline Tours. There may be a short break here as we change drivers, or it may be necessary for you to change buses. Our staff, however, will inform you if that is the case. If you are leaving us here, please ensure you have both your belongings and your ticket with you.
As a final note, we would like to take this opportunity to thank you for choosing Starline City Sightseeing as your preferred method of seeing Hollywood, and look forward to seeing you again in the near future. And please, if you have appreciated the work of our bus driver on this tour, tips are very much appreciated by them, although they are totally at your discretion.
Thank you.